safercigs.co.uk. Sponsors are the Haze Hour.
And hello, good evening and welcome to Monday here on vapertrails.tv. My name's Dave Dunn. Beside me is Keith Herbert. Say hello, Keith.
Hello.
And in the cat house, strangely enough, is Kat. How are you diddling, Kat? All right?
I'm absolutely fine. Hello, everybody. Hiya.
There you go. That's the three of us, the three mouseketeers, as it were.
Three stooges.
Who's more? I'm Larry Keith's curly. Who's more?
It's got to be me again.
Well, you kind of got to Sochi if you are. By the Pirates are on good tonight.
Aye.
I was thinking that.
Yes. Oh, as soon as they hear my voice, that's it. They're away.
They do, right? Yeah.
They do that when they hear my voice. Yes. Tonight we've got good news. Good news. Because I was watching the European Parliament earlier on, and there is some good news. And then we're going to be talking about the Puritane, and I've got some video of that. And we have a beginner's guide, and I don't quite know, well, I do know what order I'm going to go in. The video on the Puritane is quite long because I went out to Boots to buy it, and we've also got some audio of a purchase being made in York. It's going to be a cracking night tonight, it is, one way or another. But of course, we can't actually do the show until we've done the titles, isn't that right, Chris?
Tickle time.
Tipple time it is. It's tipple time. Tipple time. Tipple time. Tipple time would be good, but I've got no booze. So, hello, good evening, and welcome to the 1, 2, 3,
the Haze Hour.
Hour.
Would you say this programme is democratic?
No.
Why?
No, it's not democratic because Chris and I have little conversations behind the scenes and we decide what's going to happen, then we tell you sometimes.
Well, if it was democratic, we should have a vote sometime on the title music.
You'd lose, Keith, you'd lose.
I know, I probably would, yes.
It goes without saying. As true as there's vapour in the air, that type of music's staying. For the time being, we'll do a special show for you one time when we've got nicer type of music. Now, right, here we go. Yes, Whip It Up 69 said it, it's because Kat's in charge, and she is as well. She is. Right, now, here's the thing. We all know that over the last week or so, probably the last fortnight, we've been pushing like hell for the split and separate. We think that might well have gone out of the window, but we still won't know until tomorrow for sure. However, today in the European Parliament, this happened. Watch.
On the votes on Wednesday on Mrs. McEvan's report on the tobacco directive, there is a request here from Mr. Callanan as chairman of the ECR group, and I received this in writing, that the vote because of technical changes to the text would have to be deferred. On the 21st of February, Mr. Callanan informed me that because he didn't deem these changes to be technical but political, that the vote ought to be deferred. I've received a similar missive from Mr. Hoyle. Orally. Those are letters that I have received. Pursuant to our rules of procedure, however, this motion needs to be made in plenary before the vote takes place. So maybe I could just tell you that I have received your letters, but you have to understand that that's a motion that needs to be put forward. On Thursday, the EPP has asked to have a...
So that happened at 4 o'clock, just after 4 o'clock today. Martin Callanan and this is the important part, Mr. Herbert Reul of the EPP. He's the leader of the German EPP contingent in the European Parliament. Basically said, it's not good enough. We want to chuck it back to the Envy Committee to have a look at it. Now, what the chances are of that succeeding, I do not know. However, if the ALDE group, headed up by Frederik Arias, decides to back this motion, if ECR decides to back the motion, if EPP decides to back the motion, and certainly the German faction of EPP looks as though it's going to, if Poland and France and all of the other EPP members come together on that one, and if UKIP and their group also get there and vote, there is every chance that this could be sent back to the Envy Committee to be looked at again, and all of the nonsense potentially and possibly sorted out. They would have to go through line by line and agree on stuff. Now, as I say, what this needs from us as vapers now is to get hold of every MEP that we can and say, look, this is going to be proposed before the vote on the TPD in the European Parliament on Wednesday morning. Please support the motion to get it sorted, because the process has been done wrongly and it needs to be done right. They need to look at it again. I'm told that it might just fly. Word on the ground is it might just fly, but it needs vapers' voices. So you know what to do. Get the emails going, get the tweets going, get the phone calls going, contact everybody that you can. They're all in Strasbourg, and there is a lot of backing for this. So there you are. Now, it's Article 18 where all of the amendments have been done. I'm just looking at this. It's Article 18 that needs to be sorted out. And yes, it wouldn't mean that it fails in first reading. No, I'm just trying to see what's going on. Yes, Moonlit said it right. I'd rather ifs than bugger offs. Look, it's a chance. It's a potential. There is a possibility. We need to get onto this and get everybody told that they need to be supporting the ECR motion and the EPP motion from Callanan and Reul to get this sorted out, right? We need to be doing this. Thank you, John Knott. Matt says, consider it done, DD. I think it's good news. I think this is it's a light at the end of the tunnel. And to me, if we've got a 1 in 4 chance of making it work, let's see if we can even the odds up. Okay, there you go. That was the good news. There are moves afoot to help things out. As Neil Roff has just said, it's a chink of light, that's something. So there you go. As the Furious Fury 79 says, come on the folks, let's wrap some knuckles. Let's do that. What do you reckon of that, Chris? Has that brightened you, Danny?
Of course it has. It's excellent news. It means all the fighting we've done for something. And with a little bit more push from us, you never know what we could achieve. Who would have thought we would have got this far, eh?
Well,
who would have thought
it? Exactly right. I mean, when you look at it, when you think about it, you know, 14 months, 15 months ago, less than that, 13 months ago, it looked as though they were all going to be meds.
Yeah.
And in that length of time, it's got to the stage where I think the... By God, they are loud, guys. I would think that the majority...
Well, they've heard the news. What do you expect?
Well, they're happy parrots. You can't beat it, can you? The fact of the matter is, we've done a hell of a lot. We have done a hell of a lot. The vaping community over the last 12 months has done so much. Let's give it this last push. Sorry to get all political, but it's good news. There's a chance here. There's a chink in the armour.
Callanan's a North East MEP.
He is. In fact,
I thought I'd heard the name.
In fact, I'll go to something else while I think on, because you've heard of the Northern Echo, haven't you, Keith?
Yes.
Yes, I've got fine for it now. Here we are. Let's go here. And this here is the Northern Echo, where it says, look at that, Monday 24th of February, North East MEP calls for e-cigarette users to help him fight draconian new laws. This is by Joe Willis, the regional chief reporter. And it says, a North East MEP has called on users of electronic cigarettes to help him fight draconian laws which would regulate their use. Martin Callanan claims a proposed ban on refillable e-cigarettes alongside heavy restrictions on all but the weakest so-called vapours would stop people from using the gadgets to quit smoking. The European Parliament will vote on Wednesday on the Tobacco Products Directive, which is aimed at introducing measures to discourage younger people from smoking. These include a minimum pack size of 20 and large health warning labels. However, Mr. Callanan argues that while they are still harmful, e-cigarettes are a preferable alternative to tobacco. The Conservative MEP said scores of North East users had been in touch asking him to defend their right to continue using electronic cigarettes, but he needed more people to contact him. He said, electronic cigarettes are offering many smokers the opportunity to come off tobacco. By regulating many e-cigarettes out of existence, we risk unintentionally sending people who've stopped smoking tobacco back onto this more harmful product. I'm not saying that e-cigs should be unregulated, but just that they should be regulated according to the benefits they bring to those people who are trying to give up on tobacco. The MEP is urging users worried about the ban to contact him at martincallanan.com. That's martincallanan.com. Former 60-a-day smoker David Dawn, 58, from Sunderland, has campaigned against the reclassification of e-cigarettes. He said, I am afraid that the EU could be about to make a big mistake by over-regulating and limiting choice, which will simply lead to fewer people switching. That cannot be a sensible approach. Blah, blah, blah. Ilse Rutter, director of anti-smoking North East campaign group Fresh, said her group recognised the role e-cigarettes could play.
Really?
Now, 12 months ago, she was dead set against them. However, she added that nicotine was still a highly addictive substance. The sort of glamorous advertising we are now seeing, including link-ups with celebs and football clubs, risks making smoking more attractive to children. There are also concerns about quality control of cheap imports and whether they are effective. This is why we support the EU Products Directive.
So have you met Callanan?
Oh, yes.
Right.
Yes.
So clearly that's had an influence. I mean, is he a vapor?
Nope. No, he's not a vapor.
I mean, that's really significant, that.
Absolutely it is, yes. And I will say something as well. Before that all occurred, in the EPP, I was watching earlier on, and I will pull this out and show it on Thursday, there was what I assume was an MEP, and I'm going to try and find out who it was, with something about the size of this dingo, I nearly said dildo, about the size of this dingo, and he stood at the back with his MEP's corduroy jacket on, giving it hot licks and blowing great plumes in the parliamentary chamber, yes, in what they call the plenum. So it's all good stuff. And yes, and Disco Des has pointed out, it risks making vaping more attractive than smoking. Brilliant. Brilliant. It's all good stuff. There you go. Chris, what do you make of that?
What do I make of it? As for Martin, what can I say? The man is an absolute, absolute complete star. He stood in our corner right from the beginning. Mm-hmm. And he's never backed off. He's just continued pushing and pushing and pushing. And what can you say? You know, he's been our voice. And I'm so proud of him. I really am. So proud of him.
Very significant, that.
It is, isn't it?
I must admit, I'd always thought he was a Labour MEP. I didn't realise he was a Conservative.
Yes.
Right.
Conservative, absolutely, yes. And I've got to say, from December the 19th, when this all first started, he's been there fighting for us, and he's still fighting for us. This is brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. Now, Chris, I think I'm going to take the advert slightly early.
Okay, Doc.
Because I want to move on to the Puritane stuff. But before I move on to the Puritane stuff, it's around about 20 minutes, is this piece of film that I've got. I'm sorry, Joseph. Joseph just said, is everyone in the North East called Dave Dawn, even the women? We are, aren't we, Dave?
Aye.
That's right, isn't it, Dave?
You all right, Dave?
Aye, canny Dave. You all right, Dave?
Fine. Nice to meet you, Dave. You as well.
Yeah, that's how it all goes. Yeah, right. Oh, stop it. Let's go to the adverts, and when we come back from the adverts, we'll go straight into this video about the Puritane. I went on a journey. Now, I did say that I wasn't going to be actually filming anything, but the way it turned out, I might have done. So there's little blotchy out bits here and there. It's got nothing to do with anything other than making sure that people are kept an ear, none in, and a mouse when they need to be. So when we get back off the adverts, we'll have a look at that, but we'll take the adverts now. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Div not gone nowhere. Hell, isn't that right, Dave?
That's right, Dave.
All right, Dave. Right. See you in a minute, Dave. Ta-da.
Super6.co.uk sponsors are the Haze Hour.
Here we go then, it's time to get away to Boots, and I'm going to go up the one in Durham and see whether I can get my hands on one of these Puritanes. So off we pop. As I said, I'm going to go through to Durham in the first place, because that's probably one of the biggest ones around here. And it's a nice drive, because I really want to know how a pharmacist is going to sell me, particularly, an e-cig. Well, there it is. That there is Boots, and that's where I'm going to be going. And we'll see what we see. I have no idea what's going to happen. I don't even know if they've got them in, to be truthful, but we'll give it a go. Okay. Thank you. Hello. I'd like to try one of the Puritane things, please.
Was it the starter kit that you wanted?
I don't know. I wasn't expecting them to be quite that expensive, I've got to be honest. I'll take one of each. I think the starter kit and the disposable. Are they in different strengths?
Yes. Yeah, there's a 16 milligram and then the other one's 11 milligram.
I want the strongest one.
This one's a 16 and 11.
Right.
Get a regular and medium in that one. And the starter kit. And then that one's the full strength and just the cartridge.
Full strength is?
The cartridge is all.
Yes, I know, but what strength is that?
Oh, that one's 20 milligrams.
20?
Yeah.
And you can't get a starter kit with 20?
No.
It's a bugger, isn't it? Okay, I'll take the starter kit and I'll have one of the disposables, please.
At this point, the young lady wandered off to see the pharmacist and there was quite a long conversation. I have no idea what they were saying. I've got no idea what the topic of conversation was, but whatever the topic of conversation, she came back to sell me them quite shortly afterwards.
So you don't smoke any more than you would a normal cigarette with those ones. You just smoke it as you would a normal cigarette.
How long will they last? Yeah.
They'll last. That one's the equivalent of 70 cigarettes. And that one's 35 cigarettes.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting.
Is that okay?
Yes, fine. I don't, no.
It's
£30.98. Well, there you go. Isn't that interesting? Not a damned word. So back to the car we go. And I'll try and talk to you on camera. Right, well, there you go. I'll have edited that around a little bit, but as you heard, you can get 20 milligram. Interesting that. In the refills. The refills were just too much money, $8.99 for two. And it says on here, smooth taste, pharmaceutical grade nicotine, puff equivalent of 70 cigarettes. Puff equivalent is what it says. Can you read that? Yeah, I think you probably can. So that's what I've got. And I've also got the disposable, which says the puff equivalent of 35 cigarettes. Before use, please read reverse for further information. And where's it made? Made in the UK, it says. Pharmaceutical grade nicotine made in the EU. Produced for Fontem Ventures BV. Produced for Fontem Ventures BV. Interesting. And there's a European patent application pending. Equivalent means that 10 puffs last approximately as long as one regular size filter cigarette. So it's expecting 350 drags out of this thing. Is what it says. Look at all that lot on the back. Alright, how do you get it out then? It's one of these. That's how you do it. 16 milligram. in a disposable, and I bet it's got a red end on. Well, it's diddle off. So, not exactly difficult to buy, is it? Oh, that was a proper one, reminding me it's there. We'll have that out. Actually produces quite well. Which is interesting. And certainly from the point of view of driving, being as how it's an auto battery, now I am quite tempted to go to AN Other Boots. I mean, that one had lots of stock, and that's in the middle of one of these retail parks where there's everything you can think of. Well, not everything you can think of, but a lot of things you can think of. So what I might do is I'll have a Dodge down to Washington. It's a town centre in town centre branch of Boots, in the middle of the galleries in Washington, and there's a VIP stand not too far away, and it would appear I've got this covert filming thing because I've had a look at what happened. I shall have some blurrage to do, but I shall do the blurrage because obviously I haven't asked permission. I may have to change her voice as well, but I don't think she was the pharmacist. She did go and have a natter to a pharmacist and spent quite some time nattering to the pharmacist. I kind of want the pharmacist to come and talk to me. So far, it's just like buying anything else from behind the counter. As an example, there is a... This is going to sound awful, but you can get Caniston liquid. Now, Caniston, as many ladies will know, is for thrush. And thrush is a fungal infection. And while I believe yogurt is generally perceived to be quite good for that, in the ears, I used to quite often get fungal infections in the ears. It's with wearing earpieces as much. And she it's a little bit difficult to put a tub of yogurt in your ear. Stop now, David. Yeah, but you can buy Caniston liquid over the counter, and generally speaking, they don't ask much other than what's it for. And when you tell them it's for fungal infection in the ear, they just give you it. In this one, you just smoke it like you would a normal cigarette. Smoke it. Yes. Interesting. Doesn't taste like a tab. Actually tastes a lot like Eco Pure. It's been so long since I've had a cigarette, I can't remember how much you actually get to blow out of one. But if this is going to be the equivalent of 30 cigarettes, or a puff count equivalent to 30 cigarettes, well, that would mean I would need two a day. That's 17 quid. If it's true, and somehow I doubt it, that would be 17 quid versus 24, 25 quid for 60 fags. So on that basis, it's probably, you know, it's cheaper, not by much, but cheaper. But then people are so used to being ripped off mightily, I feel, by the cost of NRT. A day's worth of NRT is anywhere between £8 and £10, depending on which brand you buy. If it's one of the acknowledged brands, you know, the brands, and I'm not going to mention them, then it's going to be closer to the £10 mark. If it's one of the own label brands, then it's going to be substantially cheaper. But the fact of the matter is, the patches are very little more expensive than Band-Aids, Elastoplast, which is a trade name, of course, but very, very little more expensive to produce, because they are effectively an elastoplast with nicotine in. Nicotine acrylate or polar acrylate or polar flex or whatever it is what the, and it just releases gently and slowly through the skin. Not expensive to make, but bloody expensive to buy. And I suspect that what they're seeking to achieve with this is kind of parity. This is the level playing field, of course, that they're always on about. We want a level playing field between NRT and e-cigs. And of course, the Royal Pharmacists Society, R Pharma on Twitter, has this morning punted out its stance on e-cigs and saying that pharmacies did not be selling them until they are medicines, and then they should only be sold, get this, on the same basis as NRT. I wonder why that is. Is that because, do you think, there are now public health experts, some of whom I actually respect, that are saying it might take 6, 7 or 8 quit attempts with NRT to be successful? Work that out. You're going to have 6, 7 or 8 quit attempts. You're not going to do 6 or 7 or 8 quit attempts during the course of a year. This is going to take forever. And while you are doing your 6, 7 or 8 quit attempts, you'll also be smoking. Who benefits out of this? Because at the end of the day, I'd give it a go, and if it didn't work, I wouldn't give it another go. Because as a very, very wise man once said, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing time after time and expecting it to be different when you do it. Well, I'm here to tell you, if you've had 5 goes using NRT, whether it's patches, gums or whatever, there are only really... Well, now isn't it interesting that there are perhaps 6, 7 or 8 different kinds of things? There's the oral spray, there's the inhalator, there's patches, there's 3, there's gums, there's 4, there's lozenges, that's 5, and there's the new strips they've come out with, that's 6. So you're going to try all different ones? Nah, I'm sorry. If that's not marketing, I don't know what the hell is. Colour me cynical if you wish, but seriously, 93% of people that try NRT are failed by it. It does nothing for them. That can't be good.
Can I order the same thing back?
I was looking for the Puritanes.
What's it called?
It's an e-cig, electronic cigarette.
Oh, thank you. I haven't been sent to yet.
You haven't got them yet? Any idea when they'll be in?
Those Puritan, the new e-cigarettes,
that we're in? Oh, no, they said by the end of the month. Well, with the 24th today, so they should be coming in any time.
Yeah, they were supposed to be in today, I believe. Yeah, so a press release on them.
We don't get a delivery on a Monday. We get our delivery tomorrow. We alternate day delivery.
Well, that was a bust. By Tuesday, everybody should have them. But at least the lady in the second one made no attempt to sell me something different, which is good. I think they've just been told to sell them. People want them, sell them. But we'll have a better look at them in the studio and see what they're made of. David Dunn in the car on the way back to the home.
And here we are, back in the studio, with some Puritanes. There they are. I've bought them.
That whole thing really got up my nose.
Did it? Why?
It did.
Tell me
why.
Well,
you went into what was obviously a large boot store, right? First of all, I don't know how you found them. Did you go across to the nicotine replacement section?
We'd already been told that they were going to be behind the counter, not on the shop floor. So I knew I was going to have to talk to the girlie behind the counter.
So the first thing that hits your eye is weight loss. I mean, they weren't significantly displayed, were they?
No, not particularly. And I've got to say, much like yourself, when I went across and saw it was weight loss, I thought, aye, get on, get at the fat lad again.
So what were the links between Boots as a large pharmaceutical setup and the makers of those?
You mean Imperial Tobacco that owns Fontaine Ventures?
Right.
I have the feeling that they met at the e-cig summit.
And did there appear to be any notices saying that, you know, you had to have proof of age? I mean, I know it wouldn't apply in your case, but...
Hey, I look under 18.
I don't know, the whole thing just seemed to me to be a... I don't know.
Well, I don't know.
Right, this is...
As Lorian has said, Lloyd's are having the Vibe on the floor. So they're out on the shop floor just as you would buy out.
Well, as I said to you earlier, I went to an Asda pharmacy, an in-store pharmacy yesterday, and there was a display on the counter in the pharmacy. It wasn't on the shelf. There was a display. I mean, I didn't take much notice as to what the product was, but it was an e-cigarette. So if it's in one Asda, it's obviously going to be in all of them.
Well, you were saying earlier on, Chris, that you'd been, was it Tesco where they had them in the pharmacy?
Tesco had them, and this is the big supermarket one, not the little small ones, had them in the pharmacy. They had them on the shelves along with vitamin supplements. And they also had them on the shelf next to the lottery tickets on the tobacco counter.
Right, and in Sainsbury's, they have them displayed on the tobacco counter. Obviously, the tobacco products, the cigarettes, etc., are behind these doors.
Mm. Yeah.
But on the counter in Sainsbury's, there was a display.
Well, chat's just been asking, would anybody under 18 be able to buy these? And although there is no under 18 law currently in effect in the UK, I want to borrow a 14-year-old.
Yes.
And take a 14-year-old to a Boots and see what happens.
Test purchase.
Test purchase with a 14-year-old. Let's just see Now that we've worked out how to put an iPhone in your top pocket on some tissues. Well, nature's forgotten. I potted with cotton. And
I must say, I've tried much worse than that.
How
long it lasts, another matter.
The hue. I'm not going to go too far into it, because when we looked at, Matt Gluggles looked at them yesterday on Dave's Tackle Box. And to be honest, he's right. They're neither now nor summer. I'll play with them a bit and report back on them. But thus far, it was £31 I took for the team. Out my own back pocket. There'll be no expenses on it. And at 16 milligrams, somebody said, "You're getting any throat hit?" You're having a giraffe, aren't you? Throat hit out of 16 milligram.
The only way you get throat hit out of that is if you hit yourself at the back of the neck with it.
Oh, I never thought about that. Hang on, I'll try. Just a minute. Oh, nah.
Apparently, Andy Oakley says Wilkinson's have got Sky 6 on the shop floor.
Have they?
Mm-hmm. Now, what I did notice in Tesco, the ones that were on the aisle were the disposables,
mm-hmm.
not the rechargeables. And I think that was simply because of cost and the likelihood of pilfering.
Mm.
I don't think there was any other reason for it than that. But I have to say, watching that bit video you showed there, Dave, like Keith, I'm bloody furious. There are a lot of young people who are anorexic sufferers, to say, you know, to give it its proper name. And to put them next to a slimming product after
exactly.
the sort of features that have been in the Daily Mail. Sorry, did I name that paper? No, of course I didn't.
No.
No, I wouldn't do that.
We never mentioned the Daily Mail.
No. Regarding nicotine and shisha being used as a slimming product, which is absolute rubbish, and to put them next to Ally as they did there, I think is totally unforgivable. I really do. They're the ones that make all this fuss about gateway products, and they do that.
Yes.
Yes.
No.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know, I'm 100%
exactly.
in agreement with you, Chris. And I tell you something as well. If anybody read the back of one of these things, I don't know whether I can get it up on camera awfully well, but I'll try. From top to bottom, as it were, there you go. And this is just on the back of the disposable. Read before use. Cartonizer contains nicotine E, liquid keep out of reach of children. Danger! Toxic in contact with skin. If on skin, wash with plenty of soap and water. Remove immediately after all contaminated clothing. It's hazardous to health, intended for use by adult smokers, not suitable for use by persons under the age of 18, pregnant or breastfeeding, and coming up on the, you know, or persons who are sensitive or allergic to nicotine and should be used with caution. What? Adverse blah blah da blah 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 blah. It would scare the living crap out of
so
anybody
you read
that didn't know what they were.
You read that, then you read the name of the product, which suggests purity.
Yes.
I don't get where they get the name from.
I think somebody's taken the mickey, because it's French for Puritan. Joyless enjoyment crusher. Anyway.
Yes, but the man in the street would see it as purity.
Well, of course. It's all marketing. Anyway, there you go. That's what's going on. I really, really do hope that they get not suitable for, Whip It Up said, not suitable for under 18 use. Actually, under 6 would I. Anyway, there you go. It is what it is. No flavoured ones, just tobacco. Well, it's not even tobacco. As I say, it tastes like there's a bit of ethyl maltol in there.
So did you say £31?
For the two of them, yes. £23 for the rechargeable and £8 for the disposable.
Right. Yes.
So there you go. There you go. It's just, yeah, the capacity of the tank is, let's go to camera. There you go. Boom. That's the cartomizer. And if I stick it beside a vape one, which I happen to have one handy. Clickety bonk. There's the vape one beside it. So you can see. Stand them side by side.
And that's the equivalent of, did you say 35 cigarettes?
It's quoting 35 cigarettes, yes, per carto.
And that would hold, what, about a mil?
It'll hold a bit more than a mil, I think. I'll pump it out and see how much I can get in. But
so I should be smoking 5 times 35 bags a day if I was back on cigarettes?
Aye.
Okay.
There or thereabouts. Make of it what you will. Moonlit has said, Keith does not seem to be a man impressed.
Not by the setup, no.
No.
Not at all.
Nah. I'm dead pleased they've got them in there. It might introduce people to e-cigs that otherwise wouldn't get them. I didn't get the interview with the pharmacist I was hoping for because I want to know what the hell they're doing. I want to do a test purchase with a 14-year-old. Outside of that...
You want to try the one in the bridges, which is often overflowing with pharmacists.
Which one's that?
The one in the bridges.
Oh, the boots in the bridge. Oh, well, we might have a look at that. We'll have a day out in Sunderland, Keith.
Yes.
We'll have an e-cig day out in Sunderland. Do you fancy an e-cig day out in Sunderland, Chris?
An e-cig day out in Sunderland? Because
it's the Park Lane place as well.
Is your passport valid for there?
I'm not going to try and be the 14-year-old.
Oh.
Keith's the littlest.
Me, with a wig.
Have you got a spare wig for him?
A wig.
I'm sure we can find a wig for him. And we'll put him in a school uniform.
Yes. Right, oh, kinky.
With shorts.
Kinky.
I think I know what will happen when he gets back home. Wait till I tell Vicky.
What?
She'll be waiting for him with open arms. Come in. Have you been a naughty boy? Get over me knee while I spank your bum for you.
What an imagination you've got.
I filmed it through your living room window, man.
Oh, all right.
Let's take.
Always comes down to base level.
It certainly does. Let's take. Chris, we might overrun a little bit tonight.
Spying up my front passage.
Pardon?
We'll
take some adverts, and when we come back from the adverts, Davey Malik's going to be talking to you. But we'll be back right after this. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't go anywhere. They're in school uniform.
Save the Six, sponsors of the Haze Hour.
Yes, while the adverts were on, I was just reading in chat, and yeah, no, I'm not happy about them being where they were, and I wouldn't really recommend it, but if somebody happens to be there and they happen to buy them, then that at least gets them started on the right road. Talking about
it'll be interesting to see if in other boot stores, the displaying of them's the same.
Well, yes.
You know what I mean.
Yes, I do. I know exactly what you mean. at the end of the show, just to play it all out, Matt Gluggles, good lad that he is, did a test purchase in York today, and I've got some audio of that.
All right.
Apparently the girl thought it was a tablet.
So clearly there's been no staff training in how to sell or market the product.
Not, it doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like it. Anyway, like I say, anybody going and buying one of those is likely to be a beginner. And we have decided that we're going to do a series of beginner's guides as well. It's quite unusual. It's quite a video heavy night tonight, for which I apologise, but I've just felt the Puritane thing had to be done. But this beginner's guide, Davey's done this, and it's well worth a watch. So if you're new to vaping, or if you're new to VTTV, this doesn't apply if you're an old hand that's been around 5 years. But if you're new, have a watch at this. It's quite apposite for today. Click.
Hi everyone. Since the turn of the year, we've seen a massive intake of new e-cigarette users, particularly since the Chris Choi Tonight Show, and also since the whole media explosion about e-cigs. So what we wanted to do, we've seen a lot of new people in chat, and a lot of people are watching on YouTube afterwards. We wanted to put together a kind of a beginner's guide. Now, it's obviously, those of you who are already using and have been for a long time, you know this stuff, and you know it can be quite complicated. I know that when I first started, and I went onto the forums and Facebook pages and things like that, and a lot of people were chatting about things, and I was like, "What? Just what are you on about? I haven't got a clue." So we're putting this together now for newbies. But also, if you are an experienced user, then please watch it and pass it on to someone who you think it might help. So, to start with, what we're going to look at is what is known as first generation, or cigalikes. Now, these are what you will find in supermarkets, petrol stations, newsagents. They're popping up all over the place. And so, there are two different types. First of all, you've got your disposable one. Some of these say that they're the equivalent of 20 or 30 cigarettes, which don't listen to that. But basically what you need to do, what you use these for, is to replace the cigarette. It looks like a cigarette. So you can buy them in singles. They cost between £5 and £8, I think. Or you can buy them in packs of five like these. So what you basically do is, it looks like a cigarette. You pop the top cap off and there you go. Now this particular one, it's got a squidgy end, it's got the same weight as a cigarette, it feels like a cigarette. Now what you've got here is an all-in-one device. You've got a battery, this white bit here, and you've got a cartridge here, but it's all attached together. The cartridge holds the nicotine. And at the tip here, you've got an LED light, which will light up when you take a drag. So that mimics smoking perfectly. And for many of us, for me, I use this type of thing to start with. Now they are effective in their own way. It works, it makes you feel like you're having a cigarette because you're holding it like a cigarette. That's my opinion, but there you go. It doesn't much taste like a cigarette, and you don't really get that hit from it. But it does mimic it, so it can help. But like I said, these are disposable ones. So once you get to the end of the battery life, that light on the end of it will start flashing. And so once that starts flashing, it's about to run out, you throw it away properly. It's a battery, so dispose of it properly. Now, alternatively, with first generation, you can get rechargeable ones, which is probably the better option. Now, these can cost around about £15 to £20. So here I have, I've got a Vibe rechargeable one, and I've got an E-Lights one, and there are others available. But again, they look like cigarettes, and they mimic the act of smoking, but you can recharge them on a USB port. So I'll get this open, it's brand new. So, in this particular one, this is the Vibe, you get your little case to keep them in. There's one rechargeable one, there's your second one. You get a little instruction manual and a USB charger. Okay, so once again, this one actually has a little pull tab on it, so you have to pull that off first of all before you use it. And it should, oh, there's one on top as well. Take that one off, and that should be ready to go. So again, the same thing, LED light, battery, cartridge, but there is a difference. Right, again, mimicking smoking, but the difference with these are, you can separate them. So there's your cartridge, and there's your battery. Now, all it is when the LED light starts flashing on the end of this, you get your USB charger, put it onto your battery, and plug it into your computer. Charge it up, and you use the second one that's in that pack while you're waiting for this one to charge. Then your cartridge, these you buy separately. They come in different flavours, I believe. But it means that once this runs out, this can keep going, and then you buy refillable cartridges. Oh, sorry, not refillable. These aren't refillable. You buy replacement cartridges. You just simply get a new set, stick it on, and away you go again. It's as simple as that. So that is, there's one more thing I want to make, and it's a very, very important point. When you're charging your battery, only use the charger that came with it. Don't use someone else's. Don't use a charger that came with a different device. Only use the charger that you got with the e-cig. That's a really important point. So that, in a nutshell, is the two different types of first generation or cigalikes. Next time, I will talk about second generation. And it can get a bit complicated, so it will be more detailed. But that is, if you're first starting out and you're using a cigalike, that's what they are. It is, quite simply, a battery and a cartridge that has a nicotine in it. You can have it refillable or disposable. Use it however you want. Enjoy your experience. One final thing, actually, I do need to say. Again, when I first started vaping, I got really confused with everything that was going on. People were talking about all these different things, and I was like, "What? Just what the hell are you talking about?" So I asked people. I just typed in there and said, "What's this and what's that?" Just remember, this particular community of ours, the e-cig community, every single person is helpful. So if you have something that you want to say, if you don't understand anything, if you want to ask a question, ask, and there will always be someone who will help you out. So ask the question, we'll help you, enjoy your journey, and I will see you next time when we will talk about second generation devices. Thanks very much for watching. See you later.
There you are. That was, well, Davey Malik with part one of the Beginner's Guide.
I thought that was excellent.
I did.
I mean, you know, there's a demand for that. We've talked about a book that takes you through this, but I mean that's a far better idea.
It's brilliant. I love the idea of somebody that knows what they're talking about, sitting down and making it nice and simple. And that was that's definite kudos.
Really good
to Davey. Thank you, Davey. And he's going to keep doing it, and that's great. We'll keep on playing them in.
Yeah,
that's excellent stuff.
I pass on a little message?
Of course you can.
Please, I've had a PM from Sprotty.
Right.
And he just wants to thank Vapor Trails and the Vapor Trails team for all the help they've given him. And he's made me promise to pass it on. So there you go. That's nice, isn't it?
It is. Yes. And you're more than welcome. That's why we're here. We're here to help where we can. I mean, I, for one, certainly get things wrong sometimes. But if we can help, we will help. That's why we set this up, isn't it, Chris?
Well, all we're doing is we're talking from our own experience and giving our own opinions. And, I mean, we learned our lessons right back at the beginning of Vapor Trails when we were doing things like juice reviews, remember? And I can always remember one night when I was doing a juice review on the Witching Hour, and I said, it tasted like when you open the door of the dishwasher.
Yes, I remember that.
And you think, what the hell have I just said? You know? And we learned that everybody's different where it comes to things like this. And we're only passing on what we've learned. That's all we're trying to do. But we're learning from you guys as well.
All the time.
They're passing on to us. That's what makes this really good.
Yes, all the time. We learn all the time, and I like it. Somebody's just asked about decent 18650s for sub-ohm, and the new purple E-Fests that I looked at last week or the week before, they're good. Max Height is saying in chat, I'm going to read a whole load of this out, that she rang the local council today in Nottinghamshire, and while on hold, they played the Enjoy e-cig tune. That's good. And I should also point out that the vapour that you can see floating about did not come out of the Puritanes. They have come out of a scrape on top of an iTaste 134 running at 11 watts with a cotton wick and a six-turn pseudo-micro coil. I just thought I'd mention that. There you go. Purple E-Fests, they're definitely one good way to go. And you can get them at Safer Seegs, our sponsor. So I just thought I'd mention that as well. Somebody's also been asking, I think it was Rosie, asking about arranging meetups. If Daz had been here, I would have said, talk to Daz, because actually, no, I wouldn't, would I? Has he arranged it yet, Chris, do you know?
Are you talking about the knees meet?
The knees meet, hell? Is it sorted yet, pet?
No.
Right, everybody in chat, can you please type in, Daz, get the bloody knees meet sorted. It's nearly March already. We want it sorted. But to answer your question, Rosie, you can set a meet up. You just, as was said in chat, find a local pub or hostelry or venue that knows what you're on about when you say, can we have a few people together? Get an estimate of numbers, set it up, and once every couple of months, once every 3 months, once a month. There's all kinds of various different vape meets go on locally. Set one up in your local area and get people there. Why not? I know they happen regularly around the Midlands. And yes, brilliant idea. There you go. Chat said, Daz, get the bloody knees meet sorted. Thank you, Egomaniac and Kibster. And everybody else that's done. Yes, get it sorted. Yes. I hope he's watching. Chat's just got
the message, I think.
I love our chat. Our chat's the best chat on the face of the planet. Look at that. Hey, I tell you what, that's probably a good place to bring the show to a halt. Have I missed anything?
Well, you haven't, but Daz obviously has. He must be away to have a pee or something.
he could have a whole pod full of them while that's going on.
No, I think we've covered everything.
Lovely jubbly. I hope the stream's held up for everybody on both sides. Have we got any reports in of any drops on the SVP stream?
We've had a couple of short ones, and that's been it as far as I'm aware.
Oh, well, that's good.
So everything's fine.
Excellent. Good, good. And the YouTube stream appears to have held up, which is all good. I'm liking this. I'm liking the way it goes. And I'm going to say, hello, Elorian's dad. How are you doing? Nice to see you in. And nice to see all of the new vapers and the new viewers that have come along. It's been a great pleasure to have you. Yet again, I need to give my big thanks to Chris for handling the vaccine stuff and coming along and doing what she does, which she does exceptionally well. And to Keith, me old mucker.
Yes. Back to Boots.
Back to Boots. We're going to go to Sunderland to Boots.
I think so, yes. Yeah,
we'll have a trip out to Sunderland to Boots.
And ask for the pharmacist.
Ask for the pharmacist and say, hey, are these things going to do me any bother, hell, pet?
Be interesting to see how he projects them.
Well, yes, indeed. She?
Oh, she, sorry.
He or she? Well, he. We haven't got to be sexist anymore.
We haven't,
you know? No. Because if we're sexist, cat knows where we both live.
Yes, I do.
She does,
and
yes.
She'll come round and she'll put the thigh-length boots on and the stockings and suspenders and the whip.
And that's and frightening.
Well,
you're not kidding.
Speak for yourself. I'm fond of a treat, hey.
Well.
Right, yes, we're going to have to go. We've got to call it to a halt. We have overrun something we don't normally do on the Haze Hour, he said. Lying out of his teeth. Thanks to everybody for watching. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow night for Mark or Van Basten. Wednesday for Team Talk, that'll be a special one. Thursday for VT Talk, that could be a special one as well. And then it'll be back round at Dave's Tackle Box on Sunday and RY4 Radio every night of the week at ry4radio.com. Until we see you all next time, from all of us here, vape on, vape hard, and do not let the bastards grind you down. Until next time, from all of us, take care.
Bye bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Sponsors of the Haze Hour.